Today we're going to talk about the switch end stop on the Rumba 3D printer board. Now I need to explain a couple of things real quick. We have a row right here for our X-Min, then we have our X-Max, then we have our Y-Min, then we have our Y-Max, then we have our Z-Min, and then we have our Z-Max. This row right here is our voltage rail. So this will be 5 volts. The center rail will be ground, and the rail over here of pins will be our signal pins. So we're gonna test this on the X-Min. So I'm gonna connect the black to our ground and our red to our signal for our end stop. And then I'm going to create a circuit by clicking this down. So in a moment, I'll show you how to load the Marlin firmware so that we can test it. Okay, before we can actually program the Rumba board, we have to connect the USB. So we're going to connect this side to the Rumba board, and the other side we're going to connect to the computer. And you're going to hear a beep. In a moment, I'll show you in Marlin how we're going to test it. Okay, the first thing that we want to do is we want to open up the Marlin-bugfix-1.1.9. Then we want to open up the Marlin subfolder. Then we want to open up boards.h. And we want to search on Rumba. So the board that we're looking for is board_Rumba. So we're going to copy that. And then we're going to close out of this. And we're going to press M on the keyboard. And then we're going to open up the marlin.ino file. Okay, now we want to connect to the configuration.h tab by selecting it. We want to do a find on motherboard. And we want to replace board_ramps_14_EFB with what we just copied. So we're going to paste it here. And then we're going to search for end stop. And inside here, we have a bunch of different settings. Currently, these have no comments, so they're not able to be not used, so they're usable. In this case, the ones that do have comments will not show up in Printerface. Then down below, we have pull-ups that we can set. So if you get a float state, where like if you take a multimeter to measure the voltage on your ground and signal pin, and it's around 0.9 volts, that's a float state. So if that happens, you can always remove the comment to deal with that. But in this case, we're going to ignore that. And then down below, we have the ability to change or invert the logic of the end stop. For instance, if we're using the X minimum end stop and we go to check the status, and it says that it has reached the end of an axis when it has not, we would change the false to a true. And if it's the opposite case and you want the case to be the opposite of that, you could also invert the logic. So next thing we're going to do is we're going to select the board that we're going to be using, which in this case is the Mega 2560 for the chipset. So we're all good there. And then we need to select a COM port, which is COM port 7. So we're going to press the upload button, which will compile and then upload to our board our current firmware configuration. And in a moment, I'll show you in Printerface how we're going to test it. Okay, we're in the Printerface folder, so we're going to open up Printerface. We're going to connect to the board. And the first thing we're going to try is to type M119 and press enter. And currently, the Xmin says open. The other two say triggered, but there's nothing connected to them, so that's okay. So the next thing that we want to do is we want to actuate it with our finger and then test it again. So I'm going to show you how to do that.
Okay, so I'm moving my finger over it.
Now I'm going to press M119 again and see what the status is. And now it says triggered. So if I remove my finger and I press M119 again, it says open. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.